Okay. All right, man. So, okay. Speaking of hardest hits, all right, give me some advice here because, you know, I got a mouth. So sometimes I'm out in public, right? Honestly, you know, one of my biggest fears is because like people, I'll always say, man, I'm afraid to get in a fight in public. And yeah. Here's the reason.
Why is that?
Because I used to be an EMT, right? Okay. I used to drive an ambulance and I used to work in an emergency room. And I cannot tell you how many people I had that went into a coma, right?
Just from hitting their head,
from
on,
hitting
the
their head on the ground.
Yeah.
And a lot of them were sucker punched.
Yeah.
A lot of them thought the fight was over. Right. Mm-hmm. And then boom, they get hit in the head. Right. Yeah. And then it's not necessarily the tough guy. And he had this great hit. But if you're not expecting it,
see,
right,
those are the ones you don't see coming.
The ones you don't see coming.
No,
right.
I'm telling you, that do the most damage.
Yeah. And so my big fear is like, I'm going to get into like, you know, some altercation and then I'm going to get sucker punched, fall and hit my head, or that I'm going to do something and somebody's going to fall and hit their head and die.
100%.
Right. And now, you know, my life has changed. So anyway, so I always want to be prepared for that street that street fight when it comes, right? So give me some advice, man. I'm in a street fight, right? Not with you, but with a normal guy.
I think it depends too. Like I've been in like situations where big fights have broke out and like the first thing that like, you know, I'm not going to try to hop in the mix of something, especially if they're not doing anything to myself or like one of my friends or family members. But it's like, but the first thing like I'll do is I'll find like a wall, you know, so strictly for that, especially like a corner. If it was like this, I'll just go like that way because then no one can come up and sucker punch you.
Dude, that's
you know,
smart.
You can just look both ways and you can see out of your peripherals and no one's going to come sucker punch you. So always find
a
like,
wall.
Find a wall or like a corner would be best, you know, and just kind of chill there. But yeah, if you're good. In like a confrontation
What's
with someone,
move?
I would just hit them. Like I would say I would be first. Like if you're in a, obviously.
Always be first.
Always be first. It's like, I'm saying like, also it's like now, like, especially I'm always trying to avoid things and I have for
that's
a long
a
time.
Always
like,
try to avoid.
Yeah. Like I'll try to like be the mediator or talk things down. Like, hey, it's all good. Like, sorry, you know, swallow your pride. But sometimes that's hard. And I felt like when I was younger, that was really tough. If someone's like saying something to me and then like, even sometimes like my wife would be like, cause she knows who I am. She's like, don't say anything. I'm like, it kills me inside, you know, like, and sometimes I just have to do that. But, yeah, if someone's, you know, they're trying to say someone drunk and they're trying to,
right. It's inevitable.
You're going to fight this person.
I can't run.
I would just land a punch first, just throw a straight punch.
Straight.
Like, obviously, like you said, Liddell said, hit him in the throat. Sometimes it's hard if you have that adrenaline. Like, I feel like I could do it, but I'm saying just if you were to get in a fight right now, like maybe you'd have a lot more adrenaline. Things would slow down and be like a stressful situation. So I would just throw a straight punch as hard as you can. Aim for a target right in here, you know, anywhere. Like, I'd aim for the chin.
But make it straight, right?
Yeah, straight punch. Like, yeah. I also always think, too, most people do not know how to fight. Like, 100%. They're big and bad, and they can talk and do all this stuff. And whether the size of them, you know, that some people are just big, and they think because they're big, they can fight. That means absolutely nothing. Most people are right-handed. So I always just kind of, I would watch someone's arm too. You know what I mean? Think most people are going to throw some sloppy hook or some weird, like they're throwing a baseball. But yeah, if it's inevitable, you're going to get in a fight, I would just throw a straight punch right to their face as hard as you can, you know? And then.
Yeah. Are they going to try to be Floyd Mayweather and keep their hands down here? Right?
Yeah. It's with all
their shoulder.
Bad.
Yeah.
It's all bad. But first thing, you know, like find a wall. If a big thing is going on, you don't want to get sucker punched or people have friends. Yeah, that actually happened to me a long time ago, man.
What happened?
I got jumped when I was, let's see, this was in like 2007. I went to a bar with some friends and this is in like the summertime. And one of my coworkers brought a friend, you know, like we were pre-gaming before we got to the bars back then. And so I met him, he was a cool dude, like Samoan dude, big guy. We left the bar and when we walked out, like straight in front of me, it was him. He was face down on the concrete and this guy was kicking him in the face.
The big Samoan?
Yeah. And these were other Tongan guys. So it was like the Samoans and the Tongans, and this is in like, you know, it was like in East Palo Alto. So like
I'm staying away from that shit.
But they have a lot of things, but I'm
Samoans
saying
and Tongans.
The guy was kicking him in the face. Other guy was on his back hitting him. And like I just saw that. It's hard for me to now looking back at it. It's like I'd probably do the same thing, but instantly I see that and I don't really know the guy. I just met him. It's one of my coworker's friends. I run over there and I throw this guy that's on his back into the car. And then the guy that's kicking him in the face starts coming at me. And I'm like, okay, I'm going to have to fight this huge ass guy. And then all of a sudden I get sucker punched by someone else. There was like four of them, huge guys. And at that time I'm out on my feet because I don't remember anything. And then what all the witnesses said and stuff is I was like trying to fight these guys, and then someone else sucker punched me, and then they were doing the same thing to me. My face, that's why I have this huge scar. My face smacked, just landed straight on the concrete.
Where were your boys?
They didn't do anything. It was my coworkers, and this is the time I was in.
They weren't fighters.
No, it's, and that's the thing. I have like my coaches. I was on a wrestling scholarship, and I have all my wrestling teammates that were like, "Why the hell didn't you go out with us?" My coaches were pissed. My friends from back here, my close friends were all pissed, but at these guys because they didn't do anything. But then I was thinking about it, and I'm like, they don't fight. Like, that's probably these huge ass guys. Like, they're stressed out, freaking out. They probably don't know what to do. It's my fault for getting in the mix. But in the end, they were looking for these guys because it was like the guy that was getting beat up, the big like Samoan, we were in like the ICU. He was in a neck brace, huge guy. Damn. His face was purple and black, lumped up, looked like someone beat him with a baseball bat. And the police officer was, you know, asking me questions and saying that if it wasn't for me, you know, they were looking for the guys because it was like attempted murder. Like, he was in a bad place. Damn. And if it wasn't for me, he may have died. Like, he had so much trauma to his head. But I had, you know, I tore up my head. I broke my jaw too. Jesus. So it was bad. I shattered this side and broke this side.
God, did they ever get him?
No.
Not that it mattered.
No, not that it mattered. But it's like the same thing. Like, even looking back at it, knowing that that happened to me, I probably would have done the same thing just because, you know, I can't see.
Yeah,
I can't do that. No, but even I wasn't even like a professional fighter at the time. I always knew I wanted to do it. I was wrestling, you know, at the 4-year level, but I'm like, I just can't.
Yeah.
It's hard for me not to help someone in a situation like that.
Well, can I tell you something? If I would have been there, I would have been in a corner.
That's good.
I would have been in a corner. Other guys. Yeah, I would have been waiting. And if they would have come, man, I would have been ready.
But, Bob and Weave. Yeah.
That's the best advice I've had in a long time.